In this unit, we will discuss a sequence of rather technical results that will allow us to state the conjugate gradient method very, very elegantly and in a way that makes it practical, that makes it cheap to compute the new search direction in every iteration. And it all starts by looking at this right here. Okay? This picture will explain. We have our current direction RK. Our current residual RK. We have a space, a subspace, that's characterized as the space spanned by A times the various A conjugate directions, the previous ones. And what this here says is that we want to find the vector that's perpendicular to that subspace, and that will be our PK. Okay? Now, what that means is that we can recast this into, let's call this vector here something, we'll call it V. We notice that V plus PK is equal to our residual RK. And we notice that V is really the projection of RK onto the space spanned by these vectors right here. Well, let's think this through a little bit. What this really says here is that our vector V can be written as A times our matrix PK minus 1 times a vector, let's call it ZK. Okay? This here really captures that V must be a linear combination of A times the various search directions. Okay? Therefore, what we really want to do is we want to look at finding the ZK that minimizes the following problem. RK minus A times PK minus 1 times the ZK. We want to find that ZK. And that needs to minimize over all Z the expression RK minus A times PK minus 1 times C and 2 more. Okay? And this is a minimization problem that we've seen before. That's simply a linear least squares problem with the matrix A times PK minus 1. So now we have characterized all of this in terms of something that we know how to solve.